Hello, this is H.G. Bailey, and welcome back to Let's Play Dragon Quest IV! We're back at Lakanaba here because I have money to spend! And no, I do not want to go to work anymore. I don't need to. So, since last time, I got over 17,000 gold. And I want to spend some of it on the Cautery sword, since I got that when I was working here before. So, and fortunately, Torneko can equip it, so that's really good for him. Now, like I was saying, the way I got that money the last time was by buying the Iron Aprons at Endor and then going back to Bali Morale, selling them for, I'd recommend at least a 20% profit, so try to sell them for at least 1,800 each, and then go back to Endor, buy more Iron Aprons, and so on and so forth until you get up to about 17,000 gold. That ought to do. So now I want to fill out all my armor. You want to get an Iron Apron, an Iron Shield. Well, that's all you can get at the armor shop here, but, well, you know what I mean. So, and since I lost the Hardwood Headwear from the first time I started this chapter, I need to buy another one for Torneko there. That's the best armor in the chapter for him, so we won't need to buy anything else for him. But for equipment, that is. So, let's take a look around here. See what's changed since the last time we were here. I'm not going to talk to everyone, because a few people say the same thing, but most people have a little different dialogue, at least. So. Huh. Well, maybe he can sponsor me. Or, whatever the word is for that sort of thing. What's a curio? I can guess, but, a silver goddess statue. Huh. Remember that for later. Like, what's it called when, like, a rich person is sponsoring, like, an artist or something like that? There's a word for that, I forget, but, well, anyway. The world's gone mad! I like how they kind of break the fourth wall, where the monsters go away at the end of the chapter, and then they come back in the next chapter. So, Hardy, huh? Hardy boys? Nah. But anyway, we get more party members by talking to him now. Because, well, we're a merchant. I like how they do this in the game, how you get guest party members or more party members in different ways. Like chapter 1, you had the soldier. He befriended a monster along his travels. Chapter 2, you had a princess with her servants, right? In chapter 3, now we're a merchant, so we hire our party members, so I like how they mix it up like that. Nope. Never gonna happen. Might as well just give up. I'd say pack up your bags and go home, but, well, you're already home, aren't you? So. Well, he wants to sell, but we gotta get permission from the king first. If only there were a way we could convince him to let us set up a shop here. How do we do that? By getting drunk? By going to the casino? Hey, it's Ragnar! How's it going, man? Oh, well, a bit late for that now. Nuts. Yeah, they closed down the casino in this chapter, so. Oh, well. But I like how they give him little cameos throughout the game. It's a nice touch. Well, we don't get him in our party in this chapter or anything like that. Just, you know. Yeah, I'm looking for that statue there. I wonder if he's the guy. I never thought about that. Hey, how's it going? Well, yeah, that is true. Major in literature, what did you expect? Sure, why not? I won't fire you if you give me a good reason without using the letter E. No, but now we have more party members! Laurel, well, like he said, is a mage. That is a man, right? Oh, it might be a... Sounds like a feminine name to me, but... Well, let's take a look at the new party members that we got now. We have a bodyguard, a soldier, and a poet. Bodyguard has a lot of HP, so I probably want to put him at the front of my party. And Laurel has a poison moth knife, that's okay, but he's got some pretty good spells there. Sizz, which is like the Cautery sword, and Snooze. Unfortunately, we cannot directly control him. The because, well, the two of them are guests, so. I want to keep Torneko in the second position, because he's got really good defense, and not that much less HP than Laurel does, so. Although, actually, I think I want to keep Torneko at the lead for now, just for storyline purposes. Probably not going to go looking for the... I'm one of his regular merchants. Just act. Yeah, I'm probably not going to get to the next cave today, but, well, we'll see. I'll take a look around. Oh, really? Huh. Nah, you just clean up after. By the way, I misspoke in the last episode. Reagan calls the princess Ronnie. That's it. Soldiers are rather ill-equipped here. Remember that for later, viewers. So yeah, the princess is Ronnie, the prince is Reagan. So yeah, that's the pun. It still applies. Now the bridges are open, like we couldn't see in the last chapter there. So I like how you see how the town and everything changes. Huh. I think he would have said the same thing in chapter 2, but... well, there you go. Yeah, I didn't talk to him at the time, so... Well, there you go. Well, don't you want a kitchen knife? It's the most powerful weapon in the game in some RPG worlds. Well, anyway, let's get permission from the king to open our shop here. We'll ask his maid first. Now. Okay, let's go. Yeah, I'm Irish. We got booze. Oh, okay, he's not really going to do anything with us for now then, huh? That was rather fast. Oh, really? Huh, Zenithian sword. Green Sun Zenith? No, that's a good card. Well, remember that for later, viewers. But anyway, let's read the letter to the princess there. What do you mean, an affair? I mean, well, I suppose you are kind of secretly going out with each other, but it's not like you're going behind, you know, your real boyfriend or girlfriend's back on that. You're just, well, you're going behind your parents' back. I don't think that counts as an affair, but what do you mean by that? Your army sucks, dude. Although, his army sucks too. Well, not anymore after I sold him all the armor. But yeah, I thought I'd just do that off screen, so that way, well, it does kind of take a while. So. But anyway, let's deliver the good news. It's probably easier for us to make a profit by, well, getting our own shop than to sell to both sides in the war. It'd be pretty risky to do that, too. So, okay, yeah, we want to buy 2 Chimera Wings. I like how they make the items useful in some chapters by not giving you the spells that the items do. So, let's see. We gotta get back to Balimor. There we go. Whee! Got your royal decree, or royal scroll. I'm trying to think of a magic card. Whatever. Royal assassin? That's the closest thing I got. Yeah, your son, he's fondling my daughter, and I don't approve of that. I don't recommend that we speed things up here, but they might as well get married. What can we do about it? What's a crake? Or a crike, or however you pronounce it. I don't know. Why does everyone keep on saying, "So I will! So I will! So I will!" But, well, there we go. I like how they resolve the whole invasion thing here. It's like, oh, well, I'll just let my son marry his daughter, and then it'll be my kingdom. Or our kingdom. Kind of a Saturday morning cartoon way of doing it, but, well, there you go. Oh, you know, one thing I want to show you. Let's try using the Chimera Wing indoors. Yeah, it doesn't work in here. How it worked for the guy in the jail cell, I don't know. You got me on that one. But anyway, let's return to Endor and see if our efforts have paid off. Well, the castle is still in one piece, so that does help. Maybe might not be a good idea to walk in on the two lovebirds there. How's it going? Hey, all right, we can open our own shop now. Excellent. Oh, wait a minute. Excellent! There we go. Aww. Well, we stopped war with the power of love. Yeah, pretty much. Well, all right, let's see how much the guy wants for his shop then. I mean, there's nothing here. How much could it possibly cost? Hey, how's it going? Got the permission. Gigawatts! I mean, 35,000 gold? How am I supposed to come up with that amount of money? I mean, it could be double that, and it would take me forever to get that kind of money. Well, you know, there was that guy who was looking for the silver statue. But where is it? I don't know. I don't think anyone tells you where it is now that I think about it. If there is, let me know, viewers. I don't know. I forget. Let's try heading back to Chapter 2, as long as the portal's open here. Why not? Hey, how's it going? Your king is gone, dude. But, yeah, they won't let us go back there, so they're kind of locking us out of there with invisible plot wall. Well, okay, it's not invisible, but it sounds more ludicrous when I say it's invisible. Sword again, huh? Well, I'm sure that'll never possibly happen. Well, do the best I can, but how can we possibly come up with 35,000 gold to buy the shop? Find out next time on Let's Play Dragon Quest IV! This is HG Bailey, signing off. Have a good day!